Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm sharing 5 simple, easy and elegant, inexpensive DIY Diwali decoration ideas. And most of the material I use today for these decorations are from dollar stores and few are old items that I recycled. So all these decoration ideas are very, very inexpensive but gives elegant and traditional look for Diwali. Following this video, even kids can make this simple and elegant traditional decoration. So if you want to engage kids, this is the best option. So let's get into the video and see our first DIY. Here I have this cardboard cut into a circle and I have this old and used diyas. I'm arranging these diyas in a flower shape and I'm going to stick them with the help of hot glue gun. After sticking 5 diyas as a flower, the 6th one I'm sticking on the top of these 5 diyas. I'm using this inverted diya as a base and here I have this used tea light candle, so I'm sticking this on top of this inverted diya and I'm sticking one more diya on the top. Here our beautiful diya stand is ready. Now for the base of the stand, here I have this lids of oats boxes, so I'm sticking these 2 lids with the help of hot glue gun. Once both the lids are stick together, here I'm applying glue on the top of the lid and I'm placing this diya stand on this. With this complete diya stand with the base is ready, so I'm going to spray paint this. After spray painting, here our diya stand looks very beautiful. To make it more beautiful, I'm using diamond wrap and sticking to the edge of this diya. Here I'm using this diamond wrap and bead chains, but you may use anything that is available to you. Here you can see I'm sticking this green color bead chain in the center and red color bead chain to the base of this inverted diya. Now for those diyas on the cardboard, here I'm attaching this diamond wrap. This diamond wrap and bead chains I got from dollar store and spray paint I got from Walmart. Same paint I use it to make brass lotus diyas and you can check the video in the description box. Now here you can see this cardboard outline is uneven, so to cover that I'm using this lace and I'm sticking this with the help of hot glue gun. By the way, this lace is also from dollar store. With this, our diya stand is ready and here you can see how beautiful and elegant it is. Now for the second DIY, here I have this old used diya and the plastic spoons. These plastic spoons I'm going to align to this diya as a peacock feather and then measure the length. After aligning the spoons, I'm marking this with a marker so that it will be easy to break the spoon to adjust the proper length. Here I'm breaking the spoons at that point where I marked with the marker, and breaking the spoons is very easy because these are plastic spoons. After breaking all the spoons here, now I'm going to mark this exact point on the opposite side and then draw a line with the mark. Now on this line, I'm sticking this middle spoon with the help of hot glue gun. Now after this, adjusting the heights, I'm sticking the other spoons as well. Now continuing the same process, I sticked all the spoons and here the final outlook. Now I spray painted with the metallic gold, but you may use any color which you like. Here I'm using this blue acrylic paint and I'm painting in the center of each spoon. I'm trying to bring peacock feather shape, so I used these colors. Once the blue paint is dried up, here I'm sticking green and white kundans in the center of blue paint. With this, our beautiful peacock themed diyas are ready. So now let's see our third DIY. I have this empty oats box. I marked 1 inch distance and made circles joining the lines. Following the concentric rings, now I'm going to cut this. Here I'm using a sharp cutter to cut this, so be careful while cutting with this sharp cutters. And in case if kids are making this, please take parents' help to cut these rings. Once the rings are ready, here I'm using this gray paper. This is left out from this Ganesha project. You may check the video in the description box for Ganesha backdrop. Here I'm wrapping the entire ring with this crepe paper and I'm securing it with hot glue. Once the ring is wrapped with crepe paper, here I'm decorating with the lace that I got from dollar store. We can also use diamond wrap or bead chains or kundans, anything whichever is available with you. But here I used lace. Now here I'm using this bead chains and I'm giving an arched shape on the top of the ring. After sticking the bead chains on the top and the sides, here I have this small and cute bell, so I'm going to stick these bells as well. And in case if you don't have the pulse, you can also stick some flowers in that place. These are all just ideas, so you may plan according to the material available to you. With this, wall hanging candle holder is ready. Here I used a battery operated tea light candle, as normal candles are not safe. Now for the fourth DIY, I'm using foam sheet and I'm drawing a circle using a plate. And I'm cutting along the lines to get a perfect circle. Always make sure to draw on the back side of the foam sheet so that it will be clean on the front side. Here I have kundans of different sizes and different shapes and different colors. I got these kundans from the Walmart. I'm sticking the kundans using the hot glue. Here I'm sticking drop shaped pink colored kundans on the outline. Once the outline is done, now I'm using a bead chain and I'm sticking the bead chain along the kundans outline. These bead chains are available in different colors at a dollar store or Walmart. Now here for the third lane, I'm using white small kundans and I'm sticking. With this, third lane is complete. So for the fourth lane, I'm using heart-shaped kundans and I'm sticking. You may use any color and any shape. You don't have to follow the same thing. Check the material available to you and plan accordingly. Here, once the fourth lane is also completely done, now I'm using this red color bead chain and I'm sticking. As we used a foam sheet for the base, this can be used as a floating diya holder or even can be a rangoli diya. After completing this, I'll show you how to use this as a floating diya holder. Now with this, the base is ready. To make it rangoli diya, here I'm using this old used diya and I'm painting this with white acrylic color, and after the white color is dried up, then I'm going to paint this with the blue acrylic paint. Here you can see I'm painting this diya both inside and outside. Now after it is dried up, here I'm using blue color acrylic paint and I'm painting this both inside and outside. Once it is completely painted and dried up, now I'm going to decorate this. For decorating this diya, I'm sticking this flower lace I got from dollar store with the help of hot glue. As I painted blue color, I'm using white kundans to decorate more. In case if you want to use the same as a floating candle holder, we need to place a tea light candle in the center of rangoli because this clay diya is very heavy and it will sink to the bottom. After sticking kundans inside, here outside also I am sticking little big kundans. With this, a beautiful and elegant diya is ready to be placed in the center of rangoli. As rangoli and diyas are ready, for the fifth DIY, I'm making chowki or puja stand to place Ganesha. For this, I took a circular cardboard and here I'm using this design paper. And this design paper you can get in Walmart or Hobby Lobby or Michaels. You can get anywhere, any craft stores. In case if this design paper is not available, you can use fabric to cover this circular piece. Here I'm using hot glue and I'm sticking this design paper to the cardboard. Once the cardboard is covered with the design paper, to give an elegant look, here I'm using this flower lace and I'm sticking as a border. With this, first step of chowki is ready. To elevate this to a little height, I'm using this cardboard ring wrapped with the crepe paper. Make sure to use a strong cardboard ring. I have used the empty oats box to make the ring and wrapped with the crepe paper. You can also paint this ring, but this is quicker method. Here you can see base of chowki is ready. Now for the second step, here I used green color contrast to the color that I used for the first step. Following the same process, I'm sticking this paper also to the cardboard. Once it's done, here I'm sticking the flower lace. This second step of chowki or puja stand is ready. So I'm sticking this second step to the first step. Here are two beautiful steps of chowki are ready. So for the base of this chowki, I'm decorating with the bead chain. And finally, with this simple but elegant chowki or puja stand is ready. Hope you all enjoyed watching the video, and if you like the video, please consider subscribing to Homemade Flavors and press the bell icon for more interesting videos. This is Rupa signing off for today and see you in the next video. Thank you.